The first thing you're going to need is Virtual Steward from overdate.gg. It was formerly known as Race Department. So once you download that, you basically extract the contents from it to any folder of your liking. Just make sure that it's not in the C drive. Anywhere else is fine. So once you have that extracted, you can run this guy as administrator. I have already. So you open that guy. First thing you'll see is setting up the ASSETTO CORSA folder. Then you need the replace folder and the reports folder. This is not really important. It should be populated by itself. But the most important bits are these two here. So you have to point this to your ASSETTO CORSA folder. Usually it would be this if you haven't changed anything. C program files, C maps, comp, and ASSETTO CORSA. If you want to find out what the location is, you can just go to Steam, go to your library, ASSETTO CORSA, manage, browse local files. And this is your Steam directory for ASSETTO CORSA. Once you have that handy, you put that here. And then you would find your replay folder, you will put that here. Usually it is directly in the documents folder, ASSETTO CORSA, replay. So once you have that here, you'll paste it here. Once you have those two set up, you're going to load your replays here. If you have set up your replays folder already, you can just navigate by car, by date, by player, by track, or all replays. So if you know if it was you, you can just go by player, and I have my two names here, so you can just go all replays, by track, whatever. You get the idea. You pick one. So let's say if I had to pick this guy here. So I click this, then I click load replay. So it'll load it here. You notice how this is the track here and my car is here. So next step is a bit important. If you just need your car in the Drift AI server, you go to players and make sure you have just your name in this list. The way to do that is delete everything else that is not your name. You can just go over this and then just delete this. Keep deleting all the players until you just have your name and the track lines if it's around here. This is not really important, but you can right click and disable it or enable it and you'll see the track lines. Now, the next part is the most important bit. You have to right click the name of the car you want to see on the server and it has to be grayed out. If it's not grayed out, you won't be seeing the car in the server. Right? Once that is out of the way, you have to figure out which part of the replay you want as the AI or the Drift AI. So the first thing you do is scrub through and see which run is the one you're looking for. I know for a fact that the last run that I've done here is what I need. So I know for a fact that this is the start line. This is the run that ends here. So I'm just going to bring it here, let it sit, bring the first marker up here. Once you bring the first marker up here, you notice how the marker below, the seek bar below, just snaps to this beginning big. That's because this portion represents this part here, the selected part here, the green part. So we have to find, now that we have selected the start point, we have to select the end point as well. This is the end point. From here it went all the way till here. Just snap this back here. Once you have done that, you see it's just this lap, right? So once you have selected the lap, now you have to, you have to enable the replay, looping the replay, and then you should only select timeline. What that means is it's only going to replay or loop the replay within the confines of the green bars here, which is what we need. Once that is done, you can hit play and you see it starts playing that bit. You'll notice in a second here that once the run ends, it will just snap back to the start here. All right, so that's the setup bit of the Drift AI. Now all you need to do is go to the server tab here and then make sure the tire blankets are on. If you want it, you can change anything here if you like, but just honestly keep it at default and it should be fine. Start the server. you'll get a link here. You can just click it directly and it should take you to the server right there. This is the server that you were looking for. This is the Drift AI server. It has the replay driver or the car already in there. This is the Drift AI that we are looking for. And there's already another slot in here that you can use to join and tandem with. Like, that's all you need to know to set up a Drift AI server.